Hi, my name is Pushkar, and today we are going to talk about information theory. Now, information theory is not really a machine learning algorithm, so we'll try to first understand why we need to learn information theory. Usually, you could teach a whole course on information theory, but for now, it is sufficient to know the basics. So first, we'll try to understand where information theory is used in machine learning. So consider this to be any machine learning algorithm. For example, let this learner be a decision tree learner. Now we have several inputs, x1, x2, x3, and one output. For simplification, let's assume that this is a regression problem. That's why we have one output. We want to ask interesting questions like, how is x1 related to y, x2 related to y, x3 related to y? Why do you want to ask such questions? If you remember from our ID3 algorithm, the first step is to find out which input best splits our output. So we need to find out which of these x1, x2, or x3 gives you the most information about y. So we have to first understand what the word information in information theory means. In general, every input vector and output vector in the machine learning context can be considered as a probability density function. So information theory is a mathematical framework which allows us to compare these density functions so that we can ask interesting questions like, are these input vectors similar? If they are not similar, then how different they are, and so on. We call this measure as mutual information. Or we could ask if this feature has any information at all. So we'll call this measure entropy. So we are going to find out what these terms mean, how they are related to machine learning in general, and we'll briefly look at the history of this field.